This is a video for Math 123. This video gives instructions on how to find a weighted average using Excel. I'll be using an example out of our in-class activity labeled Weighted Averages. You will find instructions for the Excel part on page 5. You might want to get these instructions out and try them along with me. The example I'm going to do involves finding a weighted average of a salary. You'll notice in this example, the company has 4 employee levels. If I asked what the average salary at this company was, it wouldn't be fair just to take those 4 numbers, add them up, and divide by 4, because as you can see, only 2% of the people at the company earn $500,000. Most people earn $63,000. So this is a great example where I would want to use a weighted average. Before I open up Excel, it would be good if you knew how to find a weighted average by hand. Here I've done it with good old pencil and paper. My salaries, the percent of employees who have each salary. As I said, it wouldn't be fair just to add those up and divide by 4. Instead, I'm going to take 2% of 500,000, I'm going to add that to 4% of the 125,000, to 70% of the 63,000, and add that to 24% of the 36,000. If I was going to do this calculation, I would want to follow order of operations, multiply the percent times the number first, get those 4 values, and then add them up, because remember, we need to multiply before we add. You might want to try this just to practice with your weighted averages. You would get a value of $67,740. Let me open Excel, and we're going to enter the same information. Okay, right now I'm using Excel 2007, but all the same commands will work in 2014. Okay, so you see I've copied the box that is in the example. Let me work on my formatting a little bit. If you haven't watched the previous videos, there's a couple of ways I can format my cells. I highlighted my cells and I'm just clicking on Format Cells. I like to put a little border around my cells. I'd also like the values in column C that I've just highlighted, I'd like those to be dollar values. Easy shortcut just to click up there and click on the dollar symbol. Can go a little bit further if I want, open up this number box, maybe get rid of those unnecessary decimal places. Okay, in the percent area, notice 2%, I typed 0.02. But if I highlight those and click on this percent symbol, now they will appear as percents. If you haven't watched the previous video, Excel does have an average function. But if I use my average function on these 4 values, it just gives me an average of the 4 numbers. Again, not very meaningful. We're more interested in finding a weighted average. I'm just going to type weighted average here. It doesn't actually do anything. I'm just setting up a label. I'm actually going to put a formula in cell C10. Microsoft does not have an easy function to find a weighted average. You will need to know how to calculate a weighted average. Let me pull up my picture again of how I did it by hand, and let's think about how we're going to do it with Excel. So we did it by hand. I want to multiply the percent times the salary for each one of these values. When we put formulas into Excel, we need to type an equal sign. Everything that I type will also appear in the function bar up above. Now I could actually type the values, 2%, 0.02, and the number 500,000. That's not what I want to do here, because while that would work, it wouldn't be taking advantage of using the spreadsheet and the cell references. I want to type cell references here. So 2% appears in the cell D3. When I type D3, you'll notice that Excel very helpfully highlights that cell for me, so I'm sure that I chose the right one. Now I want to multiply. I'm hitting my shift key and the number 8 to get the asterisk there for multiplication. And I want to multiply that times cell C3. And you can see it highlighted that in a different color. Okay, now I'm going to add that to the next percent times the next salary. So the next percent is in cell D4, which I want to be multiplied times cell C4. Plus cell D5, times cell C5 plus cell E5. See how helpful it is when I highlight those boxes for me? D6 times C6. And when I hit enter, I get my weighted average that I got when I calculated it by hand, $67,740. Now, why would I want to use Excel to find weighted averages? Why would I want to use cell references instead of just typing numbers? If I click back in cell C3, watch what happens when I change the CEO's salary to a million instead of half a million. Watch what happens in cell C10 when I hit enter. The value changed. They changed this value to 250,000. It changes my weighted average. So when I change them back, I can click my undo button. What if I change the people who have 70% of the $63,000 salary? Let's all give them a raise. Let's raise them up to 80,000. What does that do to our weighted average salary? It makes it closer to that 80,000 figure, because that's what most people are making. Okay, this example is going to be really helpful for figuring out your first project and how to make a grade book. You're going to need to figure out a formula very similar to this. So I recommend that you try this and that you try the homework problem on the weighted averages homework.